Brothers and sisters in Christ, I welcome you to this last Sunday of the year 2020. It's been quite a year, to say the least, but we know that God is good. Amen? And God is good all the time, and that all the time, God is good. And we can choose to look at 2020 as a terrible year, or we can choose to look at 2020 as an opportunity to glorify our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, who has been with us the entire time. I pray, Father God, this night, this day, that you will be with us in this service and with us next week as we begin a new year. So I welcome you today in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in it. Before I invite Rob to come forward and begin our service, we have some gathering music today from Ashley Sutphen. And I'm going to invite Ashley to come forward now.
Come, they told me, ba-rum-pa-bum-pa. King to see, ba rum pa bum pa. Our finest gifts we bring, ba rum pa bum pa. To lay before the King, ba rum pa bum pa, rum pa bum pa, rum pa bum pa. So to honor Him, ba rum pa bum pa. I have no gifts to bring, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, that's fit to give a king, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum, rum-pa-bum-bum. Shall I play for you, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum, on my drum? Mary nodded, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum. The ox and lamb kept time, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum. I played my drum for him, ba-rum-pa-bum-bum. I played my best for him, ba rum pa bum bum, rum pa bum bum, rum pa bum bum. Then he smiled at me, ba rum pa bum bum, me and my drum.
Good morning, friends. It is a beautiful morning to be in worship with you, maybe in your locations, but here in the sanctuary, we are connected by the Spirit of God, amen? It has been a year of challenges, but we are overcomers, for He has overcome the world. We do want to thank Ashley and her father, Wayne, for his compliment, for the beautiful music to frame our worship this morning. It is time that we go seek God, ask Him to be a part of this. Would you join with me where you're at in your holy places in our opening prayer? May we pray. Glory to you, Almighty God. Let the saints below and the saints above praise your holy name. You formed us as a people and claimed us for your own. You are the beginning and the end of our salvation. May your Spirit impress your truth on our inmost being and receive us in mercy through the sacrifice of our Savior and Redeemer, Jesus Christ. in whose name we pray. And God's people said, amen. Amen. We certainly pray that you are well, that you have the strength of the Spirit, and the Spirit is holding strong within your faith. May we reclaim this faith with the Apostles' Creed, our call to worship. Join with me. I believe in God the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, and in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried. The third day he rose from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sitteth at the right hand of God the Father Almighty. From thence he shall come to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. Amen indeed. As we come to children's time, we have a beautiful introduction this morning with Hayden, Zoe, Ada, and Layla. Be blessed with our children's time.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me, yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me, the Bible tells me so.
Wow. Wow.
Oh, hello, hello there. I am Clyde, the Christmas walrus. And how are you? I hope you've had the merriest Christmas. Did you? I hope so. You know, every Christmas, even this one, is special. I remember 15 years ago, when I joined a new herd, they could have tusked me, but they didn't. They showered me with Christmas love, and that's all the difference in the world. This Christmas may be different, but it's still special. I've got my good friend, Mr. Rob, to tell us about his special gift. Mr. Rob, what's going on in your world?
Whoa! Thank you, Christmas walrus, Mr. Clyde. Hey, friends, I can tell you what's going on in my world. It is wonderful. Say, do you remember a couple days ago at Christmas when you had the tree all set up and the presents were there waiting for you? Yeah, it was exciting. Oh, and then you got into it, didn't you? Oh, you got that cheetah onesie. Oh, you wanted that one. Oh, dreams come true. Oh, and then you kept digging around, and you... Hey, look! Those special walrus slippers. Oh, just for you. But let me ask you. Did you open up every gift? The most special one? What could that gift be? Oh, I know you dug around there, and you were tearing paper and everything else. But the best gift is God's gift to us. Jesus came into the world at Christmas, and he said, I have come to save you, to make life better. Jesus is God's gift to us because he loves us. You know, it's never too late to open up Jesus, to open your heart to him. My friends, as we're going into 2021, we have every moment to say Jesus is part of my life. This baby becomes the man that gave his life for all of us. And every moment is a new birth for you. Friends, the new year is going to be good because Jesus is part of our lives. Can we thank him? Can we thank him and thank God for his gift to us? Oh, gracious Father, loving Father, Father who gives. Lord, you gave us the greatest gift of all. That is Jesus, your Son, because it is the gift of love for every one of us. Lord, help us this day and every day into the new year that we can be your people and we can take your love and give it away. And this we lift up to you in Jesus' name. And all of God's people said, amen. May this day and every day be the best day because Jesus loves you. Take care. Happy New Year. Clyde, Clyde, get out of the cookies. Get out of the cookies. I told you to get out of those cookies.
Amen, my friends. We would ask Ashley to come forward again and to sing a beautiful song in this Christmas season, Away in a Manger. Be blessed by her beautiful gifts.
Friends, on this last Sunday of 2020, we are exploring one of the praise psalms today in the sermon that is entitled, Why Does Christmas Matter? So let me share with you from Psalm 148, the first 13 verses. Hear now the word of God. Praise the Lord. Praise the Lord from the heavens, praise Him in the heights above. Praise Him, all His angels, praise Him, all His heavenly hosts. Praise Him, sun and moon, praise Him, all you shining stars. Praise Him, you highest heavens and you waters above the skies. Let them praise the name of the Lord, for He commanded and they were created. He set them in place forever and ever. He gave a decree that will never pass away. Praise the Lord from the earth, you great sea creatures and all ocean depths, lightning and hail, snow and clouds, stormy winds that do His bidding, you mountains and all hills, fruit trees and all cedars, wild animals and all cattle, small creatures and flying birds, kings of the earth and all nations, you princes and all rulers on earth, young men and maidens, old men and children, let them praise the name of the Lord, for His name alone is exalted. His splendor is above the earth and the heavens. This is the word of God for the people of God. Will you pray with me this morning? Almighty and most merciful God, on this last Sunday of 2020, we have much to be thankful for, and yet we also lament at a difficult year. But we know that you have been with us throughout all generations. You are worthy to be praised no matter what, because you love us and because you are with us always. I pray that you would be with me now and with this congregation as we worship you the best way that we can, that you would let your presence be known, and that this worship would be pleasing to you, and that my words would indeed be your words, Lord. We offer all of this in the name of Jesus Christ, who is our Lord and Savior. Amen. Well, friends, it's over again. It's over for another year. Christmas Day is done. The anticipation, expectations are complete, whether they turned out like you wanted or not. It's done for another year. The artificial trees will be packed away. The manger scenes will be put back in their boxes. The angel or the star, whichever you place on the top of your tree, will be carefully stored away along with all the special ornaments. The cut trees will find their way to the curb with the rest of the trash. We will now have to pay the credit cards off, find a place for the gifts that we really didn't need, and understand that another Christmas is in the books. What's it all about, anyway? Does Christmas still matter? Truth be told, 2020 has not been one of my favorite years. A pandemic has taken the lives of hundreds upon hundreds of thousands of people. Politics have created disunity, even to the point where good Christian people have been at each other's throats, spouting divisive posts. What does it matter, this thing we call Christmas? Why do we bother anymore? Oh, we know it's about loving each other, right? We know it is about serving the poor, which we have done. We know it is a time to grant forgiveness and to ask for forgiveness. We know it's a celebration. But do we really know why? Is it more than just an emotional response to a really good Bible story? Is there more to it than gifts and cookies and Hallmark movies and manger scenes and evergreen trees? Is there more to it than trying to pretend everything is perfect in our world, in our families, and even in our churches? What is it all about, and does Christmas still matter? A man walked up to Pastor Rick Warren one time, and I have had this same conversation with people too. I suppose all pastors have had similar conversations at one time or another, like Pastor Warren had with this particular man. Anyway, he walks up to him and he says, "Pastor Warren, what must I do to get to heaven? What must I do to get to heaven?" And Warren shocked him when he said, "Well, you're too late." The guy wasn't sure what to say. He didn't expect that answer. "What do you mean?" he said, "it's too late." "What needed to be done for you," Warren says, "was done 2,000 years ago. All you need to do is accept what has already been done. It's grace, my friend, grace plus nothing." Friends, the Bible says it's by grace that you have been saved through faith, and this is not from yourselves. It is a gift of God, not by works, so that no one may boast. Even today, when I try to explain grace to the unchurched, And even to some within the church, they get a blank stare on their face. They cannot comprehend that grace is a gift that comes to them free and clear. And I understand the apprehension in thinking this must be too good to be true, right? This grace thing, it must be too good to be true. Because in our culture, quite frankly, everything is performance-based. Everything. Our schools, our work, our sports, our bank accounts, our families, everything seems to be based on performance. To succeed in this world, one must perform. We are told, and this is modeled everywhere, that if it's to be, then it's up to me. It is driven in our heads. We hear this all the time. I've heard people say it, that God helps those who help themselves. They quote that as if it's scripture. It is not scripture. It comes from the book of Ben Franklin, actually. God never said that. Listen, good works, deeds are great, goals are good. Working hard is what God wants us to do, but not for our salvation, but as evidence of our salvation. And friends, that is what Christmas is all about. Yes, it's a celebration. Yes, it's reconciliation. But it is also, again, as I said on Christmas Eve, about salvation as well. And that's why it matters. God does not grant us salvation based upon any performance. We don't work to gain God's approval or to earn our place in heaven. God never suggests, not anywhere in the Bible, that our approval and our inclusion is based upon works or deeds or some kind of a performance rating. The Bible says this: when people ask Jesus, what are the things that God wants us to do? And I'm paraphrasing here. Jesus says this: the work that God wants you to do is this. Believe in the one He sent. Believe in the one He sent. Salvation is about trust, not trying. Christmas matters because God came to earth in Jesus Christ to save us by His grace. Christmas matters because God started the process that was put in place in the dawn of time to save us from our sins. Christmas matters because Jesus is the way, the truth, and the life. And that for the Christian, there is no other way to the Father except through the Son. Christmas matters because God's love is put on full display through Jesus Christ. God's love evidenced through grace is the difference and is the hope for all creation. The psalm today that I read is the third of five psalms that are known as the Hallelujah Songs. Hallelujah translates as praise God. Psalm 146 through 149 uses the words praise God over and over and over again. The 150th psalm, the last psalm, serves as a doxology for this group of psalms. It ends with the verse. The 150th psalm, the last verse in Psalms, ends with this verse: let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Oh, friends, Christmas matters because God's love and God's grace has been offered to humankind without cost. At least, no cost for us. God's love has been offered up by the atoning and sacrificial death of His Son, our Savior Jesus Christ, the Anointed One, the Messiah. The cross, friends, has never been absent from the Christmas story, and it never will. I think the 148th Psalm is especially appropriate today, as it symbolizes for me a great choir of voices, if you will. It symbolizes voices being added to the praises of God from all God's creation. It says, angels, praise Him. Sun and moon and stars, praise Him. Sea creatures, praise Him. Lightning and winds, you praise Him too. Wild animals, small creatures, yeah, you're included. Praise the Lord. Kings and princes and rulers of the world, young men and maidens, old men and children, let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Christmas matters because God so loved the world that He gave His one and only Son, that whoever believes in Him will not perish, but praise God, have everlasting life. Christmas matters because, as Revelations 5 and 12 says, worthy is the Lamb who was slain. Worthy is the Lamb that was slain to receive power and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord this day. Let the choir of all creation praise His holy name. Christmas matters because we all sin and fall short of the glory of God. Christmas matters because unto us a child is born, a son is given, and the government will rest upon His shoulders. Christmas matters because Jesus, that baby who was born in Bethlehem, would become the resurrection and the life. Christmas matters because this is love, not that we loved God, but that He loved us and sent His Son as an atoning sacrifice for our sins. Oh yes, Christmas matters. It matters most because many people celebrate Christmas without knowing Jesus. They wonder why, after all the traditions are met, all the rituals and practices, that they still feel empty. They celebrate Christmas because that's what they've always done. But they have never developed a relationship with Jesus Christ, who is the reason for the season. You can have the best decorated house in the neighborhood. You can have the best dinner parties. You can have the best presents. You can have the picture-perfect family. You can have all the blessings that this material world can lavish upon you. But if you do not have Christ, you will not find true hope or true joy or true peace or the spirit of a true blessed Christmas. Christmas matters because we still live in a world where many people are lost. The good news is vacant from their soul. The gospel to them is still a foreign language. Christmas matters because it brings the truth to a lying world and it brings light into a dark world. Christmas offers salvation through God's grace and love, and that is the message we need to keep giving and keep sharing. Christmas is about God's love and His grace and the gift of salvation, the greatest gift that we can receive and offer to others. The good news, the gospel of Jesus Christ. And friends, if you're struggling today, if you are looking for fulfillment and purpose and meaning in all the wrong places, then trust me, you'll never find it. For it doesn't come in a bottle. It doesn't come in a pill. It doesn't come at a casino. It doesn't come in a place or a program. It doesn't come through accumulation of wealth or power or prestige. It doesn't come through promotions and popularity. If you are miserable and you don't know why, if you are floundering through life, if you are wondering what this Christmas thing is really all about, then isn't it time you made a decision? Isn't it time you began a genuine exploration of the gospel? Isn't it time you tried something different? And maybe that difference is surrendering your heart and your will and your life to Jesus Christ and asking Him to come into your heart. God created you so that God could love you. If life is getting you down, then isn't it worth a try? Give Jesus a try. God created you for His pleasure. He created you out of joy and out of love. And until you understand and believe that, you will never find peace. Why does Christmas matter? Jesus paid our debt. Jesus redeemed our voucher for our sins. Jesus made restitution for our sin. Jesus paid it all so that we could live free with blessed assurance and confidence as a child of the living God. Does Christmas still matter? Only you can really answer that. But I believe Christmas matters, not just because of the fact that God entered the world, but because of how He entered the world. As a newborn, humble baby, born to poor parents in a poor country, it tells a lot about the nature of God, doesn't it? That baby came for all. Came for everybody. Came for me. Came for you. He calls us to follow Him. Worthy is the Lamb, my friends. Christmas matters. Let everything that has breath praise the Lord. Let us pray. Almighty and merciful God, You have carried us through this difficult year, and we give You praise. We know that You love us, and we know that You have a plan, and we may not know what it is, but Father God, give us the faith to understand that at the end of the tunnel, Your warm light is going to be there waiting for us. But also, while we take a breath on this old planet Earth, let us praise You, for You are worthy to be praised. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. Friends, as we transition to our closing prayers, I want to share with you a few birthdays that I know about. Tom Duvall has a birthday today. If you see Tommy today, wish him a happy birthday. Also, Don Duvall, Dave Poole, and Bonnie Henry, Keith Roberts, Ira Seibert all have birthdays coming up this week. Tim and Ann Peralt also have an anniversary. As far as our concerns, we have many. And I want to share some of those with you today. Keep those families that are grieving today in your hearts, in your prayers. Also keep all of those who are suffering with cancer today. facing surgeries, illnesses. There are many that we have shared throughout the year that are still in need of your prayers today. I would be more than glad to send you a list. If you want to get a hold of me, I would send you the list of all the prayer concerns that we have been lifting up and will continue to do so. There is much need. We pray today for especially all of those who have perished from this terrible pandemic. We pray for all of those that are being touched by it in different ways. There is just so much need right now within our community and throughout the world. We lift all of them to you this day, Lord. With that, will you bow your heads and let us go to the Lord in prayer. Heavenly Father, we, your children, commit the coming year into thy hands. May it be a year in which we will live and grow stronger, stronger as believers through your presence in our hearts. And we declare, Almighty God, O merciful Lord, we declare that by faith and your providence, that the coming year shall be a year of total restoration, of total victory. For the Lord God Almighty says to us that no weapon that is formed against us shall prosper, and every tongue that shall rise against us in judgment, I, the Lord thy God, shall condemn. This is the heritage of the servants of the Lord, and their righteousness is of me, saith the Lord. So let every one of us who claims Jesus as Lord, decree that from the beginning to the end of this coming year, that we shall be like a tree planted by the riverside that bears fruit in its season, whose leaves do not wither. Whatever we do, Lord, by your name, let it be for your glory and praise, for you are a good God, and you, Lord, have seen us through a difficult time of challenge. Lord God, we rebuke this very day the forces of evil that have tried to destroy us this past year. We rebuke the evil one who has whispered lies into our ears and have caused dissension and disloyalty and judgment. And we claim victory today, Lord. And as we begin a new year, we claim that victory in your loving and gracious name. Let everyone and everything who breathes praise your name this day, for we will finish this year, a year that will go down in history. We will finish it strong, victorious, and in the Lord. And we thank you, Lord, for the coming year. We take thy word into our heart and for our life. It is only in you, Lord, that we find our peace, our hope, our joy, and our love. So here we humbly beseech thee, Lord, hear our prayers this day for all of those who are ill, for all of those fighting cancer, for all of those with surgeries and procedures facing them. We pray for the end of this COVID-19 virus. We pray for rejuvenation in the church. We pray for peace and comfort for those that are grieving. We pray for healing of our emotional challenges, healing of our mental and physical challenges, healing of our spiritual challenges. Hear our prayer offered to you this day in the name, the precious and blessed name of Jesus, who taught us all to pray together by saying, Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come and thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Friends, I pray that this Sabbath day, this closing Sunday of 2020, will be a day, a Sunday, a Sabbath where you claim victory today and where we move forward in 2021 with that victory that we have in the grace and love of Jesus Christ. May you have rest today and peace, my brothers and sisters. And may the Lord our God bless you and keep you. May He make His face to shine upon you and be gracious. May He lift up His countenance upon you and bring you peace. Amen and amen.
The Lord bless you.